Welcome to this talk on a Julia package called TiledViews. What is TiledViews? Well, if you have a larger data set, you can dice it up in little tiles, as indicated by the green regions here. When you're done with a whole line of tiling, you can of course continue with the next row. And this way, you've basically created a tiled view. The parameters that characterize this tiling are, of course, the number of overlapping pixels and the tiled pitch in each of the dimensions. If you think about n-dimensional tiling, you will find out that you actually need to provide two n dimensions to describe the tiled view. So this would be three dimensions, for example, in a 3D example, x, y, z, within a tile, and again, three dimensions to characterize the tile index. What we want is we want to realize this whole thing as a view so that we do not need to copy the data. And ideally, this view should have read and write access. What are reasons for tiling? Well, one reason could be that the raw data is already tiled, as in the case for some of the microscopy methods. And you can use this then to stitch the data together. Another reason might be that there's a limited memory to process the full data set as a whole. For example, in deconvolution, you want to send the data to the GPU, but it doesn't have enough memory to cover the whole data. So then you send it tile by tile to be able to gain the speed advantage of the GPU processing. Another reason might be that there's a slowly varying parameter, like for example, a point spread function that shifts from tile to tile a little bit, that changes a little bit from tile to tile, but is fairly invariant. And so then you can use the advantages of FFT-based processing, but you can process it tile-wise with different point spread functions. And finally, there's also algorithmic reasons, for example, avoiding to process empty space or making use of periodicities in the data of some way. So what we want is a fast read and write access, of course, and that can be done with getindex and setindex via a tiled view where we do not need to copy the data. So here's an example of a huge data set. The original data is almost a terabyte of data. If you can burn it, you can boil it down to basically about 10 gigabytes, but that will still be too big to perform deconvolution on a graphic cards for the whole data set, but with the tiling, it is possible. Now I want to dive into a practical demo of tile processing. I've already loaded a data set here, which is the cameraman that you see here. And now we're going to dice it up by this defining 50 by 50 pixels for each tile and an overlap of 20 by 20 mutual overlap. So if I do this, we have now created the tile view, and the size of the tile view now, starting from 2D, is a four-dimensional data set, 50, 50 pixels within the tile and 18 by 18 tiles. And we can now deal with this whole thing because it's a subclass of array as if we were dealing with a single array. Now we want to create a destination data set where we want to write our data into. And luckily there's a nice function called zeros like in the tiled views, which allows you to do just that. So it creates an empty new data set, really allocating some memory, which is now the resulting data we want to write in. Then we want to apply a function that I've created here called doNormalize to every one of the tiles. What does it do? Well, it simply normalizes each tile by a mean of 0.5 and a standard deviation of 0.5. Now, how can we now apply this to every one of the tiles? And there's a convenient function called getTileIterator, which iterates through the tile numbers. And so we do this by zipping together the one for the source, my view here, and this newly created destination data set. So we have source and destination available, and we can then simply apply this tile by tile to normalize function to each of the tiles. And if you now look at normalized tiles, we'll notice this. So it has, of course, sharp edges because every tile has been processed by itself. And they even override each other a little bit because they have overlap the way that they were defined. So if we do not want that, we have to do it in a different way. And one convenient way of doing that is creating a window function. So this is done by the next line here. Get window actually create such a window function, and it needs only the parameter, which is the tile view. Of course, there's also optional other parameters like the type of window you want, but how does it look like? Well, it looks about like this. As you see, it's a fluffy little window with a Hanning type behavior, and they are created in such a way that they perfectly add up to one everywhere. And so you see the type of this window is actually an index fun array, and that has the advantage that it doesn't consume any memory and it will be using on the fly processing essentially. So when we want to process now our tile views, I'm creating here another empty data set to store our result in, and then the same way as we did it before, the only difference being that we are now adding into the result data set with the window performing essentially a weight in each pixel that we are adding it to. And since the window adds up to one, we can now compare here the original way that we first did the tiling with the new way that we now have the fluffy borders. And as you see, all the borders are gone and we have nice blending between the various tiles. So there's actually another way that you can create this matching window along with creating the tiled view. So this is just a convenience function. So it's a slightly different user interface than the original one, which just specifies the overlap in as a percentage or a fraction of the tiles. But finally, there's a convenient way of doing all of this with what is called tile processing. So if you have already created a tile view, you can apply tile processing to data set, and you get with the verbose function even a nice indication of how far you got along. And then the result, of course, is exactly the same than what we had before. So after this little demo, I went to finish by mentioning that tiling has not only advantages because you have overlapping, it is slightly slower than processing the original data. You have to process a little bit more. You might run into stitching problems if you're choosing wrong windows, or there is some remaining boundaries in your data even after the windowing. And finally, you might run into race conditions when you're doing parallel processing and you're writing and adding into the data. I would like to end my talk by thanking Felix Wechsler, who helped me a lot with tips in the programming, and Dr. Ulrich Leichner, who provided the Drosophila data set that you nicely saw. And thank you very much for listening to this talk.